Say Kayla, thank you, Jesus. You are the ancient of days. You are the lily of the valley, the bright and the morning star. You are He who was, who is, and will ever be. Thank you, Jehovah. Thank you for today, the first Sunday of the month of May. Oh, how glad we are to see today. Because only you can give the gift of life. Only you can give the gift of a day. Thank you, Jesus, for everyone connected to us. Our fathers, mothers, brothers, sisters, everyone, loved ones and well-wishers. You have been the reason for the season. Thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We say be magnified, be glorified. Lily of the valley, bright of the morning star, ancient of days. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I want to thank God for your life again today that you are here. I believe you are there watching. And I want to say that that God that has given us the grace to see today, the first Sunday of the month of May, will give us that same grace to go through May to the end in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I see you going through the month of May. You are going through the month of May. Not just going through, you are going through in prosperity.
Amen.
You are going through in victory.
Amen.
You are going through in success.
Amen.
You are going through in prosperity.
Amen.
You are going through victoriously.
Amen.
Don't forget, the month of May has been declared the month of victory at last. The month of victory at last. It's a prophetic declaration for you. No matter the battle facing you, victory at last.
Amen.
Financial battles, health battles, the world right now is beginning to see that the coronavirus is not what it used to be. God is showing the way out. Every remedy comes from God. Yes. Whatever that will see men through comes from God.
Yes.
And I see you a success.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I'll be speaking on what I've titled, Ehe-Mwa-Narhue. A lot of persons were curious. What does it mean? Is this English language? what is this? This is my 30 years of pastoring. And in these 30 years of pastoring, I am not sure I've preached on titles, you know, in Benin language up to 3 times. I'm not sure. It comes once in a long while. And it is as a result of what is loaded in the world. Like this title, Ehe-Mwa-Narhue, there are 2 things it stands for. It depends on your pronunciation. You know, in the promote before today, I did say that there is no single English word that can carry what this word carries. Ehe-Mwa-Narhue means it was not done here. The way you say Ehe-Mwa-Narhue, it means it is not here that it is being done. So, only one word, so powerful. And I pray that as you begin this word this morning, it will be a blessing to your soul in the name of Jesus. Now, your victory over challenges in life and progress matters are not decided yet in this physical platform called Earth. Every serious decision are taken in the spiritual atmosphere, in the spiritual hemisphere, in the spiritual environment. Are more permanent than what we see. That which is invisible are more permanent. It's more permanent than the one that the eyes can see. Matters of positive destinies were concluded before we were born. Amen? I believe in destiny, but I don't believe in negative destiny. I will explain. If a man is poor and you tell me it's his destiny to be poor, I don't believe that. If a man is a drunkard and you say it's his destiny to be a drunkard, I don't believe that. I don't believe that. If a man is mad, if a man is living a life of struggling and he says his destiny, I don't believe that. But if a man is a prophet, if a man is a rich man, If a man is prosperous, if a man is a successful leader, and you say it's his destiny, I can believe that. Because before everyone was born, God programmed something into our lives. Before we were born, God decided a pattern for our life. But let me tell you, some of these things can be truncated here on earth. Now, in the Bible, Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 4, I like us to read it together. If your Bible is there with you, he said, "Then the word of the Lord came unto me, saying," here, verse 5, "Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before you came out of the womb, before your mother pushed you out, I sanctified thee and I ordained thee a prophet unto the nations." That is, before Jeremiah was born, God has already programmed his life. He has been destined to be a preacher, a voice in the land, a voice to his generation. Before Jeremiah was ever conceived, heaven has decided his mission here on earth. The same with you. The same with everyone. Jeremiah actually became a prophet. Today, we have a full book in the Bible, you know, named Jeremiah. Prophecies, everything that transpired, you know, with him, as was inspired by God, they are all stated there. And I pray for you this morning, the destiny that God has programmed for you will not be frustrated. It shall not be truncated.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ. God has a plan for you. God has a desire for you. You are here in this world. There is a divine script. And it's a good one. Don't forget what scripture says, that I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper. Don't forget that you are in his hand. He has plans for you. But every now and then, the enemy tries to do whatever they could to stop you. But I decree you are unstoppable.
Amen.
In this month of May, nothing will negatively affect your destiny.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Concerning John the Baptist, it was also said, while his father Zechariah was right there in the temple at the altar praying, do you know, the angel came and said, "Zechariah, your wife Elizabeth is going to be pregnant. The two of you will give birth to a man, a baby called John." And they hear what God, through the angel, said about John. This time, Zechariah has not gone home to even sleep with his wife, but hear what the angel said about John. In Luke chapter 1, verse 15, he said, "For he will be great in the sight of the Lord. He shall never take wine or strong drink, and he will be filled with the Holy Spirit even from his mother's womb." That means the greatness of God has been programmed. God has programmed greatness into the life of John. But he was given instructions. Like I said, divine destinies can be truncated here on earth. Yes, the man was born to be this, to be that, but now he has arrived and he's doing something else. I pray you will not with your hand truncate the destiny of God in your life.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Before John was born, before he ever entered into his mother's womb, the angel said he shall be great. The angel said he shall be great. You, before you were born, your greatness has been declared by the Lord. Your greatness has been prophesied by the Lord, and it shall come to pass.
Amen.
You see, this is why parents, you know, are capable of contaminating the destiny of the unborn child. Parents, we tell our women in church, when they are pregnant, say, we always lay hands on that woman. Always declare. Always say, "Lord, this baby, prophesy to the baby. And the baby will hear." Because right there, as you carry the baby, you can tell the baby what the Lord wants the baby to be. And you can help to order the destiny of that child. In the name of the Lord, it will be so. Now, there are parents in the Bible we're going to look at. Parents can either activate a blessing or a curse upon their children. Some persons you see living, walking around, while they were still in the womb, a curse was activated upon them. And now they are camp, 10, 20, 50 years old. They are living a life of struggle. They themselves don't understand. Because parents can actually activate a curse, activate a blessing into the life of their children when they are not born. In the book of Matthew chapter 27, verse 22, I'd like you to hear what scripture says there. From 22 to about 24, he said, Pilate said unto them, what shall I do then with Jesus, which is called Christ? They all said unto him, let him be crucified. And the governor said, why? What evil have they done? But they cried out the more, saying, let him be crucified. And Pilate saw that that he could prevent nothing, but that rather a tumult was made. He took water and washed his hands before the multitude, saying, I am innocent of the blood of this just person. See ye to it. Hear what the people said. Then answered all the people and said, his blood be on us and on our children. You could see how they involved their children. You see how they involved the ones they've not given birth to. Let his blood be upon us and our children. Some parents go to shrine even while they're carrying the baby. Some parents do all kinds of things. Even this day, you see a pregnant woman carrying a baby and see committing adultery. Carrying a baby and committing adultery. And don't you know that will affect the destiny of that child? That will affect the life of that child. Yes, we know when we are born, we can take the destiny, our destinies in our hand, and with the name of the Lord, reprogram it. Reorder it. You will see where it happened. Amen? So, parents have a way of involving even your born children. I am a Benin man, and I'm proud to be one. Right here in Benin, you see people, you know, they are making incantations and they mention their name and they talk about the children and their children that they have not given birth to. Right in the shrine. And you think those things are just for nothing? No. We know all yours can be broken by the name of the Lord. But there's more to that. Amen. So what are we saying? Some of these things that we hear, that we go through, that we see, were programmed. Satanic arrangements can be destroyed. So those people, all those people affected their children. And what did they do? They said, don't bother. Let it be upon us. Let it be upon us. Let his blood be upon us and our children. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Now listen, there is a man in the Bible called Jabez. There's a man in the Bible called Jabez. She brought a curse upon her son. Jabez is the name of the man. The mother brought a curse upon him. Why? Because when she was delivering Jabez, she delivered Jabez in a sorrowful manner. And so she gave him Jabez, a kind of bad head. And when the man grew up, his life was filled with sorrow. But he took his destiny in his hand and went in the presence of the Lord and turned things around. And the Bible says he became the most honorable. And I prophesy over you, whatever that was released into your life that is not in line with God's pattern, this morning, that yoke is broken in the name of Jesus. Whatever you are going through that is not divinely prepared to be a part of your life, this morning I command in the name of Jesus, that yoke is broken. Amen. And is destroyed. Amen. Here, 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 9. And Jabez was more honorable than his brethren. And his mother called his name Jabez, saying, because I bear him with sorrow. And Jabez called on the God of Israel. My friend, call on your God. Call on Jesus. Call on the great God that we serve, the triune God. God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Things will turn around. Jabez called on the God of Israel, saying, Oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed and enlarge my coast, and that thy hand might be with me, and that thou wouldest keep me from evil, that it may not grieve me. And God granted him that which he requested. You too can do the same. As this world begins to empower you, I decree in the name of Jesus that the Lord will hear your voice and turn your situations around. Amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every demonic programming into your life and destiny, making life harder than it should be, I come against them now in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You can be free. You can remove them. You can reorder your life. You can repattern it in line with God's design. What about Samson's parents? You see, Jabez, his mother brought sorrow into his life. Say, because she gave birth to him through sorrow. Do women give birth smiling? Do women give birth in the hospital? Watch your video. Is it not one of those causes that God pronounced in the Garden of Eden? He said, in sorrow you will give birth. But thank God, those causes have been renounced. He said, you shall be safe in childbearing. Amen. To be safe in childbearing does not mean that the pain will not be there at all. This woman pronounced sorrow upon the destiny of her son. But when her son grew up, took his destiny in his hand and reordered it. That's your own. It shall be reordered.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Look at Samson's parents, Mr. and Mrs. Manoah. They were married. And Mrs. Manoah saw a revelation. And God spoke to her. He said, look, you're going to give birth to a baby. This boy is going to be a Nazarite from his womb. So because of that, you should not drink wine. You should not take alcohol. Samson's mother was placed under strict instructions. Samson's mother and Samson's father were placed under strict instructions, and they obeyed. They obeyed. But Samson was born, and Samson, by his own, truncated the divine destinies upon his life. With his own hand, he abused the divine privileges he was enjoying. Well, that is what happens to men. Some persons, their mothers, their parents did a good job for them. But now, they are the ones destroying it by themselves. I've not seen pastor's children becoming something else. Whereby a native daughter's son is becoming a pastor. A native daughter's child is proclaiming Jesus. Because now that you've been born, now that you have arrived, and you have grown up, you can do a lot of things to change your life, positively or negatively. May you not order your life negatively.
Amen.
I've always told people, you say, my father didn't train me. Now that you are grown up, you are a grown up man, why don't you train yourself? Oh, that my parents were wicked. They didn't pay school fees for me. Now that you are working, if you really know the value of schooling, if you really know the value of education, why don't you pay school fees for yourself? Some people have worked with that counsel, and today they are smiling. They are smiling. Samson grew up, became a very strong man, a giant of his own level. Look at Judges chapter 14, verse 3. Then his father and his mother said unto him, is there never a woman among the daughters of thy brethren, or among all thy people, that thou goest to take a wife of the uncircumcised Philistines? And Samson said unto his father, get her for me, for she pleaseth me well. This was because she came home, told his father and mother that she had seen the girl she wants to marry, and this guy is a Philistine. And the parents say, no, we are under covenant to marry our own people. Why will you go to a Philistine? And he said, no, that's when I lie. Once people become not amenable to good advice, they are marching towards destruction. Proverbs 29, verse 1. He that is being often reproved, but hardeneth his neck, shall certainly be destroyed without remedy. Samson said, my word is law. You may be my father, you don't have anything to say about me. You may be my mother, but you cannot correct me. I live my life the way I want. That's how some people do. They say, it's my life, leave me, let me live it. It's my life, leave me, let me do. And you leave them. But when they have problems, they'll be looking for you. May God help us. And he went ahead and married a woman. You know the story. From that day, Samson was moving from one problem to the other until he died with his enemies that he was supposed to destroy. He became a participant in the death of the enemy of God's children. Why? Because he was not amenable to good counsel. When you are doing what is wrong and people counseling, your father counseling, your mother counseling, your pastor counseling, take it for your own good. It is my prayer for you. It is my heart desire that that which God has programmed into your life before you were born shall come to pass. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not die with your enemies.
Amen.
But as men that plan evil against you, they will die in a hurry.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, we'll look at the seed of Abraham. Wow. Ehe-Mwa-Narhue, my brother. My sister, it was not done here. And it is not being done here. Abraham's descendants were blessed before they were born. They were blessed before they arrived on this earth. Abraham's children. Abraham's children were blessed. God told Abraham several times, I will bless you and your seed. Why some are invoking curses upon themselves and their children? Some are carrying blessings upon themselves and their children. I pray for you, blessings will follow you and your children.
Amen.
Blessings will be imparted upon you and your children.
Amen.
Blessings will flow through your head to your loins, affect your born children. And when you begin to give birth to children, these children become another level of blessings to your life.
Amen.
So shall it be.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's get an instance in Genesis chapter 17, verse 5 to 8. It was just God and Abraham. Hear this. He said, neither shall thy name anymore be called Abraham, but thy name shall be called Abraham. For a father of many nations have I made thee, and I will make thee exceeding fruitful. And I will make nations of thee, and kings shall come out of thee. And I will establish my covenant between me and thee and thy seed after thee in their generations, for an everlasting covenant to be a God unto thee and to thy seed after thee. And I will give unto thee and to thy seed after thee the land wherein thou art a stranger, all the land of Canaan, for an everlasting possession, and I will be their God. God was no more talking about Abraham now. He was talking about his children. I will be their God. The greatest blessing God can give to any man is his presence. Because by giving you his presence, he has given you himself. By giving you his presence, God has given you himself. Do you know the meaning of that? Do you know what it means for God to give you himself? He said, I will be with them. Your children, I will be with them. In other words, they succeed wherever they go. You can see the reason Balaam could not curse God's people. Balaam saw the prosperity. He saw the expansion, the multiplication of the children of Israel. He got threatened, jealous, affrighted. And then he sent people, say, go and call me Balaam. Whoever Balaam curses, is cursed. Calling for me. And Balaam came. You know the story. When you get home, study Numbers 22, 23, 24. And the Bible says that this man, Balaam, was ready to do the bidding of Balak. He was ready to pronounce a curse. But God has warned him on the way. He said, don't say anything except I order it. Because God wanted to kill him on the way, but thank God for his heart, whose eyes see. That's a matter for another day. And God said, don't say anything except I approve it. He said, yes, sir. And so he went. And Balak said, okay, cause these people to say, erect an altar. In other words, I need to consult with God. Oh, my God. An altar, very important. Erect an altar. They offer sacrifices. And then God spoke to him. Hear what he said. Concerning the children of Israel. Those same descendants that God told Abraham, I will be with them. And now a man whose curse is genuine, whose curse is efficacious, was not to curse them. Hear what the man said. Numbers 23, verse 8. How shall I curse whom God hath not cursed? Or how shall I defy whom the Lord hath not defied? How shall I? He was asking a question. He was asking a question. He openly confessed. How shall I curse whom God has not cursed? In other words, these people are blessed beyond my curse. I can't curse this one. They can be killing others, but you are beyond their killing. They can be pronouncing curses upon others. Hey, you are blessed beyond their level of curse. Curse you. Before you get to where you are, it becomes a blessing. Because the only thing activated upon you between curse and blessing is blessing. He confessed. And when he was taken to the other side, Balaam looked at him and said, what have you done? I called you to curse these people. Balak was angry. He said, okay, maybe these people, they are very prayerful. Listen to me, I'm going somewhere. Maybe the people in this corner, because Israel was everywhere, and they were looking at Israel from the top of the mountain. They were looking at the children of Israel. Those ones did not know what was happening. Ehe-Mwa-Narhue. They didn't know what was happening. They did not know that while they were going about their normal business, an evil king has gone to invite a prophet whose curse is efficacious to pronounce curse on them. Just like sometimes you are in your office, you are in your shed doing your business, someone is in a coven, someone is in a shrine, evoking powers against you. It will work because you are a child of God. And let me quickly invite you, if you've not been a Christian, give your life to Jesus. It's in Jesus it happens. It's in Jesus the power reveals. John 1:12, as men that receive him, receive Jesus. To them he gave power to become the sons of God. And even to them that believe on his name. He said, okay, come to the other side. Maybe these people are too prayerful. Maybe these ones are fasting. That's why you can't curse them. Come over to the other side. Listen, there's something that runs in the blood of these people. Covenant. Before they were born, their father already seeded them to God. And so it was not really about what was happening there. It was about the curse operating in their lives. He took him to the other side. Hear this. In verse 22, in verse 20 of that same chapter, 23 in Numbers. When he took him to the other side, Balaam looked at the people. I reckon a lot, commune with God, look at what he said. He said, behold, I have received commandment to bless, and he had blessed, and I cannot reverse it. Nobody can reverse the blessings of God upon your life. Amen. He said, I cannot reverse it. Actually, a curse is a reversal of blessing. A curse is a reversal of blessing. It's a matter for another day. In verse 20, he said, surely there is no enchantment against Jacob, neither is there any divination against Israel. According to this time, it shall be said of Jacob and of Israel, what have God wrought? No enchantment against you.
Amen.
Anyone that goes to evil altar for your sake shall fall.
Amen.
Anyone that goes to an evil altar for your sake shall be destroyed.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. In conclusion, take matters to the spirit realm. Serious decisions about our lives, about our destinies are not taken here. They are not taken in the physical realm. Serious matters are decided in the spiritual realm. It is the spiritual realm that controls the physical realm. The spiritual controls the physical. Learn to take your matters to the spiritual. And you will see that from there you begin to operate. Move the hand that moves the world. There's a hand that moves the world. You cannot move the world. The world is so heavy. You can't move the world, but you can move the hand. And that hand will move the world. The Lord will bless you. The Lord will bless you.
Amen.
You want to lift your car? All you need to do is to get a jack. Put it under the car at the appropriate place. And you begin to turn the jack. What happens to the car? It goes up. Drop the jack. Try to lift the car. You are on your own. But the little, just begin to wind it. It becomes easier when you use the jack. Leave the world, but move the hand that can move the world. The Lord will do something that will favor you this month. The Lord will bless you in the name of Jesus. When decisions are taken in your favor, in the spirit realm, it is the aftermath that will be seen in the physical. The realities. Suddenly they see that God is blessing you. Suddenly they see that you are healed. Suddenly they see that you are fruitful. Suddenly they see that you are making progress. They don't know what is happening because it was not decided here. Ehe-Mwa-Narhue. The Lord will see you through. The Lord will bless you. I believe that you can borrow a cue from Jabez. If things are not going on in your life the way it should be, and something tells you or you have been told that certain things that were programmed against you are the ones working, sir, take your destiny in your hand. Lift yourself to God in prayers. Abandon whatever the enemies have planned. Reorder, and they will smile. It is well with you in the name of Jesus. This one will be a blessing unto you. You shall not remain the same again. You shall not remain the same again.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
I encourage you, please, share this word. Make a comment, like it, like our page. And very soon, we're going to introduce you to our YouTube channels where you can see all the messages the way you want it. The Lord will bless you.
Amen.
In Jesus' name. I would like to have your prayer request. Chat me up, call me with the number 0705549428 or 08023388.